In this video, I will be applying some of the new enhancements to Mastercam 2023's Deburr toolpath. Here at Mastercam, we sponsor the Witch Doctor BattleBot, and the weapon frame rails are the perfect application for these new features in Deburr. Let's dive in. Highlighted in yellow, these weapon rails hold the main weapon shaft in the front of the bot. To explore further, I'll leverage the new ViewSheet organization that Mastercam offers. ViewSheets now support grouping and color coding. Clicking on the Witch Doctor assembly group will expand that out. Click on the isolated weapon assembly ViewSheet to get a closer look. For this demonstration, we will focus on the red chamfers. Historically, the best approaches for machining a feature like this would be to surface machine it with a ball end mill, use a large chamfer mill, or even run multiple passes with a smaller chamfering tool. But what if this wasn't a flat plate? That would complicate those approaches. Being creative, it's possible to swarf this chamfer with the flank of an end mill. On a different configuration of the Witch Doctor BattleBot, that's exactly what we did. These contoured weapon rails were machined with a 5-axis swarf toolpath. Programming with a swarf creates a very efficient and effective method to create a large chamfer. Let's check out what's new in Deburr to create the same machining strategy we just saw with even less effort. Back in Mastercam, expand the first ViewSheet group and click on the finish model. This part was machined by prepping the stock, adding some Lang quick point studs, and locking it down into a 0-point riser. Though swarf works well, there is a fair amount of geometry and surface selection involved in creating it, and the chamfer must be accurately modeled, which isn't always the case. Sometimes it may just be called out on the print. And the smaller the chamfer, the more difficult programming a swarf can be. Turn on the display for the deburr operation number 2. You'll recall that in the last release, Mastercam began supporting multipasses in Deburr. Launching the parameters, this is simply controlled by specifying the number of cuts along edges. This allows you to create chamfers or radii with very little programming effort or specialty tools. Let's copy this down and turn this deburr operation into something that resembles the 5-axis motion we observed on the machine earlier. Once copied down, launch the parameters. Remember that deburr only requires picking the part model and edges to break. Having the chamfer modeled is not a requirement. If a chamfer is modeled, model prep tools like Modify Feature make deleting it a breeze. Since this new approach will now only require one pass, change the number of cuts to 1. On the Tool Axis Control page, set the machining type to 5-axis and turn on Tool Contact. Specifying 50% will put the contact point halfway up the length of the cutting flutes. Ensuring that Generate Toolpath is selected, click OK. Select and backplot the operation. With just one solid edge and the model selected, I achieved some great results almost automatically. In this exercise, I used a ball end mill, but Deburr's new support for almost any tool with a straight section of flutes opens up a lot of options. In this file, I have a few other examples programmed. Chamfer tools and taper tools of any angle work as well. Select the next two operations. The first uses a 16mm chamfer mill, and the second utilizes a 20mm tapered tool. Run backplot and observe the motion that is produced. Since this is a 45-degree tool machining a 45-degree chamfer, the toolpath is actually producing clean 3-axis motion. For the taper, deburr easily creates that big break edge with the tapered portions of the flute. Before exiting out of backplot, notice that the tool is contacting right at the midpoint of the flutes. Deburr offers control over this, so let's slide that tool a little further down the chamfer to get us closer to the tool's max diameter and the specified surface speed. Click OK and launch the parameters for the operation. On the tool axis control page, specify 85% for the tool contact. Click OK, and once regenerated, backplot it. Notice how much higher the contact point on the tool is. So far, we have been looking at these exaggerated chamfer sizes. Although many parts will have larger chamfers, the typical use case for deburr is a sharp edge that just needs a slight break. The bearing pocket for the shaft on this part is a perfect example. In prior releases, running a multi-axis deburr operation on a hole like this would require a specialty lollipop tool. Select the last operation and backplot it. With this new functionality, it's possible to utilize a generic ball or flat end mill already used for some other purpose upstream in the process. Mastercam 2023 continues to build on the already powerful and easy to use deburr toolpath. The ability to use the flank of standard non-specialty tools to deburr complex components will have you rethinking the way you deburr even your most challenging projects.